To understand how insecticides disrupt nervous functions, let us examine how the nervous system is organized and its significance for an animal. The role of the animal nervous system is to detect and collect information through the sensory systems of vision, sound, touch, taste, and smell, and to use this information to integrate the animal's functions and behavior for survival and reproduction. Let us now look at the structure and function of the insect's central nervous system. The central nervous system consists of a brain and a nerve cord on the ventral side of the insect body. A ganglion is a thickening of the nervous system where the cell bodies of the nerve cells are located. The ventral nerve cord consists of a series of ganglia. The ganglia are interconnected by paired nerves. Let us see how the nervous system functions by looking more closely at the internal structure of a ganglion. The functional cell of the nervous system is called a neuron. The role of the neuron is to receive and transmit information. The neuron consists of a cell body, which is the living part of the cell and contains the nucleus. Dendrites receive information from other neurons or from the sensory system and convey the information to the axon. The axon is a long cellular filament that transmits the information throughout the nervous system. The axon ends in tree-like branches that transmit information to the dendrites of other neurons. Information comes into the neuron as a stimulus to the dendrites. The dendrites convert the stimulus into an electrical discharge or depolarization. Depolarization means that the neuron membrane has changed from a positive electrical charge on its surface to a negative electrical charge. The stronger the stimulus intensity, the greater the dendrite depolarization. When the dendrite's depolarization reaches the axon, it changes into a strong electrical impulse called the action potential. The more intense the depolarization message, the greater the number of action potentials. Action potentials travel by self-propagation along the entire axon. The branching at the end of the axon conveys information to the dendrites of many other neurons. Information is transferred between neurons at a point of contact called the synapse. In this illustration, information comes into the ganglion on an input neuron, is transferred at a synapse to a ganglionic neuron, and is subsequently distributed to many other neurons. To understand how insecticides work, we will look more closely at how a neuron generates a nerve impulse, since this is one site for the action of insecticides, and it is key to understanding how insecticide poisoning is disruptive to the animal and becomes fatal.